Hello students, welcome to the fifth part of chapter acid, bases and salts. Let's start today's session. Let's start with methyl orange, which is a synthetic indicator. Methyl orange is a synthetic indicator. It is reddish orange in color in dry powder form. Its original color is reddish orange. Methyl orange shows red color in acidic medium. Means if you are testing any solution and you are to know whether it is acidic or basic in nature, and you are using the methyl orange as an indicator, and on adding methyl orange, if it turns into red color, it means that the testing solution is acidic in nature. Methyl orange shows yellow color in basic medium. If you are testing the solution, if any kind of solution you are testing to know whether it is acidic or basic in medium, and you are using methyl orange, if the testing solution changes into yellow color, means that given solution is basic in medium. In a neutral solution, it remains orange. It does not show any change in neutral color. Let's see this with the picture. Methyl orange indicator. Here you can see neutral pH, that is 7. Here the color is yellow of the indicator. In acidic pH, it shows the change in color, that is red orange color, whereas in basic medium it remains yellow. Now moving on to the next synthetic indicator, that is phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein is a synthetic indicator used as a laboratory reagent. Now what is this reagent, children? Reagents are the substances that are added to a system to bring about a chemical reaction, or they are added to see if a reaction occurs or not. It is a colorless solution. It does not have any color of its own. It is an organic compound. It is colorless below pH 8.5 and attains a pink to deep red hue above pH 9.5, which means that phenolphthalein remains colorless in acidic and neutral solution. If you are adding phenolphthalein indicator in acidic or in neutral solution, it does not show in any change in color, it will remain colorless. Whereas if you are adding phenolphthalein to a basic solution, then it changes from colorless to pink color. Let's see with the picture over here. The phenolphthalein indicator is over here and it is showing pH is equals to 7, which means it is neutral. So here at neutral stage, it does not show any color, it is colorless. Here in the second flask, you can see that pH is equal to 10, which means it is basic in nature. And here the phenolphthalein changes from colorless to pink in color. So in basic medium, it changes into pink color, whereas in acidic and in neutral solutions, it remains colorless. Moving on to the next topic, that is neutralization. So far we have learned, children, about the color change of various indicators with acids and bases. Now let us see what happens if we mix an acid with a base. Neutralization is a reaction between a base and an acid to form a salt and water. So whenever a base and an acid reacts with each other, they always form a salt and water. And this kind of reaction is called as neutralization reaction. Acids and bases, when mixed in right amounts, neutralizes each other. Whenever acid and bases are mixed in fixed proportion, they neutralizes each other's power. In a neutralization reaction, heat is evolved. Whenever there is neutralization reaction, means whenever an acid and a base react with each other, heat is evolved in that reaction. A new substance called salt along with water is produced. So whenever acid and bases react with each other, a new substance is formed, which is called as salt, plus water is also formed over there in that neutralization reaction. Hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide solution to form sodium chloride and water. What does it mean? Let us see with this reaction over here, children. HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, plus sodium Na hydroxide OH, that is NaOH sodium hydroxide, is reacting and form NaCl, that is sodium chloride, plus H2O, that is water. So what is happening in this reaction? An acid, that is HCl, and a base, that is NaOH, are reacting with each other and forming a salt, that is sodium chloride and water. So this is an example of neutralization reaction. The salt produced may be acidic, basic, or neutral depending upon the acids and bases used during a reaction. So the salt which is formed over here in neutralization reaction, it can be acidic also, or basic or neutral. It depends on the acid and bases which are reacting in the reaction. The next slide is about the salts. Salts are the compounds that are formed by the reaction of an acid with a base. As I told you earlier that when an acid reacts with a base, it always forms a salt. So salts are the compounds that are formed during the neutralization reaction. What do you mean by compounds over here? A compound is a substance that is made up of two or more elements. For example, you can take water, that is H2O. It is formed of two elements, that is hydrogen and oxygen. In the same way, carbon dioxide is also a compound, where carbon and oxygen are the two different elements over there which combine together to form the compound. Okay, now moving to the next point, that is they are crystalline compounds. Crystalline means in the form of crystals, as you have seen sugar and salts at your home. Now they are the crystalline compounds. These salts which are formed during the reaction, neutralization reaction, they are crystalline in shape. They are soluble in water. They get easily dissolved in water. Their solutions are good conductors of electricity, which means if you dissolve these salts which are formed during neutralization reaction in water, they get easily dissolved and they form the solution. Now this solution will behave as a good conductor of electricity, means electricity can easily pass through these solution. Ammonium chloride, copper sulfate, ferrous sulfate and silver nitrate are some common salts used in the laboratory. These are the common salts which are found in our laboratory. Here is a table in which the names of the salts, the chemical formulae and their common names are given over here. Children, you have to learn this table. Let us see the first one, the first salt over here, the sodium chloride. The chemical formula is NaCl. And the common name is common salt. Commonly we call it as common salt. Sodium bicarbonate, that is Na2CO3. And the common name of sodium carbonate is washing soda. The third salt is sodium bicarbonate. And the chemical formula is NaHCO3. And the common name is baking soda. Next salt is barium sulfate. Chemical formula is BaSO4 and commonly we call it as barium white. The next salt is copper sulfate, that is CuSO4 and the common name is blue vitriol. The last one is aluminium potassium sulfate and it is represented by the formula K2SO4.Al in the bracket SO4 bracket close 3.24H2O. And the common name is potash alum. So children, please learn this table thoroughly. And here we'll stop this session. And in the next part, we'll continue the rest of the chapter. Thank you.